Hello everyone. Let's see how to use symbolic links. These function blocks represent an invisible connection between a transmitter and a receiver. The main purpose of these symlinks is to provide a connection between hardware I/O ports and the corresponding process variables. So let's imagine that you want to take the value of a sensor from a hardware input and use it in a function block. To do that, you have to create a sensor cat like in this example. Go to the Composite tab, press Ctrl+W, type symlink multivar DST, and press Enter. Then right-click on name 1 and select Add Constant. After the path, enter the name of the variable. Here it will be sensor 1. Also put the variable QI on true. Right-click on this icon and select Interface Editor to change the type of variables in Boolean. And click on OK. Link the event INIT and INITO for the initialization. The CNF event will be triggered when the value of the physical sensor has changed. So now, let's imagine that you want to control the command of a motor through the hardware. In the cat of the motor, you can add the sensor cat modified before to activate the motor. Then, in order to send the command to the hardware, you need to import the symlink multivar SRC function block. Same as before, you need to put the variable QI on true. Enter the name of the variable. Change the type of the value and link the events and variables. Finally, drag and drop the cat motor in the application. For example, you can add a second instance of your cat and link the INIT event. Then select the function blocks. Right-click and then map to the device. Open the hardware configuration of the device. Open the Symbolic Links tab. Here is a little tip. If your Symbolic Links tab doesn't appear by default, go on General Pads and click on Symbolic Links. Or you can press Ctrl+Alt+S. Finally, you can see your symlinks variables available for hardware I/O ports or other communication protocols. That's it. Now you know how to use symbolic links.